said many in the spiritual community and even creative corporates want to go and do extremities like a trend, fulfilling their bucking list of one-upmanship to satisfy their egos. Then the next breath, believe in non-judgment. The paradox and hypocrisy is overwhelming and flawed beyond normal rational beliefs. As humans are taught in our flight or fight response to weigh up options. This is called choice, and discernment wouldn't go amiss. This in turn means people end up in the middle of nowhere. The paradox of what we call in purgatory. So with a culture they really do not understand, empathise with, or have any commonality with at all, this is cultural misappropriation at its finest. Then the same people will preach morality, equality and fairness at any given time, therefore ending up purging their venom. A polite word for shitting and puking, which is the body's reaction to a poison. Ask biologists, they confirm this very coherently. Social media and on-forum discussions of science versus pseudoscience becomes another issue of beliefs, an understanding without proof to back up and feelings and thoughts. So when people do the following. Ayahuasca. Take a South American Amazonian plant medicine, which you should beforehand the 6 weeks fast and be initiated into the tribe before taking. Whereas people go to all sorts of retreats, essentially to do with non-shamans, people who are not trained in this specific skill. Cambo. This is when they burn a frog's poison into your bloodstream and you experience of being a frog and detox. Ibogaine. Used in West Africa, and the hallucinations can make you see your birth and death of your life. DMT, you can read up more for yourself. It's an expensive trip or medicine, as spiritual community calls it, which still leaves you empty if you're not ready or prepared correctly instead of going through long-term healing due to you cannot shortcut healings for long-term results.